somebody else's writing, in a sense, when you wrote And Another Thing. Did that come about by you being approached by Douglas Adams' family, or...?
That Douglas's agent, Ed, and my agent, Sophie, worked together, and they were having a dinner, and Ed was saying that for the 30th anniversary of the first book, for the big Hitchcon, they would love to have somebody to come in and finish the story. And Sophie said, well, you know, what about Eoin? And very quickly and very easily it happened. And they rang me, and I said, oh God, no, that's terrible. And then about 30 seconds later, I said, well, I do have an idea. And but I thought it would never get off the ground, because I thought there is no way Douglas's wife is going to say yes to a kids writer from Ireland. It's about as far away as you can get. For a start, I'm only 5'7". He was like 6'4". So I thought it's never going to work.
Authors aren't normally judged by height, you know.
Oh, they are. They are in Wexford. In my house. My kids are very suspicious. They think I've already cheated them in the genetic lottery, that they're all going to be short. So every time a tall person comes into our house, they go. So I don't know, it was the maddest thing. As soon as I said yes, I began to feel nervous about doing this book. And the internet went insane. All these people going on the internet saying, this is a terrible idea. So I stopped reading the internet, and I stopped going on the internet. But then my brothers took it upon themselves to tell me what was happening. They go, hey, this guy says you're an asshole. I'm not saying that. This guy says it. Don't kill the messenger. And then, so I stopped talking to my family, and I went to the shed where I work, and I tried to recreate the 1980s for myself. So I listened to Kate Bush for the entire time, and brought myself back to my teen years. But then one day I was on Facebook, which I have since stopped. And at the side of Facebook, you know, there's a banner that says, join this society, if you love Zac Efron, tick this book. So it's random. And the box came up, join the society to stop Irish writer Eoin Colfer writing The Hitchhiker. I said, that's going out to everybody in the world. That's random. And so I immediately joined that society. And initially I was trying to protect I was saying, no, I'm a nice guy, give me a break. But that sounded pathetic even to me and whiny. So I went the other way, and I started saying, you know what? He is an asshole. I don't like him, and I know him really well. He buys his jeans in the children's department. He's a horrible person. And it was so therapeutic. I really recommend it. If you're feeling down on yourself, go on the website that hates you, and there's one for all of us, at least one. And say all the things that you're insecure about. And by the end of the day, I felt fantastic. And in a strange way, it kind of turned the tide for me, because people began...
Don't people rush to your defence then? I mean, if you knock yourself down enough...
No!
No, they don't! Oh, I thought they'd come and say, no, he's the greatest person.
I thought
person.
They would. Come on, mother. You're on the side.
What about the
Why are you on the side, by the way?
What's the point of four brothers if they don't rush to your defence?